All right, grade eights, we're coming to the end of first chapter on Japan. Hopefully you've read all the pages I've asked you to. I haven't given you a lot of assignments the last couple days, but you will have your chapter four test on Thursday. I originally said Wednesday, but we'll do Thursday a little more time. I'd like you to try it the best you can as a test. Obviously, I can't stop you from looking at your notes or anything, but I'm gonna post it at 10 o'clock on Thursday, and at 2 o'clock, I'm gonna stop it. So you only have a limited amount of time to do it. Last page to read, or pages, is 161, 162. Just talk about, did this isolation really stop everything? The answer is no. What the shoguns wanted to stop was Christianity, right? They wanted to stop the influence of Portugal and Spain because they brought Christianity with them. Well, I didn't show it on one of the videos, but there was an Englishman who ship washed up on shore, and he got to know the shogun. I think his name was William Adams. He was Protestant, so he wasn't a threat. He didn't care about, you know, passing his religion on, and the shogun was okay with that. Eventually, some of the Dutch were allowed to trade, and they became the biggest trading partner because they weren't trying to push their religion on to Japan. They just wanted to trade the goods. Korea and China still had limited access and trade. The Dutch was getting a lot of goods from China and bringing them into Japan. They were the one main country that was still allowed to have the most access was the Dutch. Some ships actually tried to even fly a Dutch flag to get into Japan and trade, but were caught and dealt with for that. So foreign influence was a little bit there, not a lot, but the main things they wanted to stop Christianity. Eventually, the Dutch brought a lot of medicine information into Japan that helped Japan increase their knowledge of medicine. They were kind of like during the Black pre-Renaissance, the Dark Ages, where they didn't want to touch the body, autopsies, that. But they started to learn medicine about why people were getting sick, so the Dutch brought that with them. So the Dutch were getting pretty rich and known by trading with the Japanese. Eventually in 1720, the shogun relaxed some of the information, some of the books that were allowed, because he wanted to learn more about the West. He was realizing what was going out there. He'd heard about, you know, the different countries, obviously, when the Englishman washed up on his shore. He's like, well, what else is out there? He asked him about it. He learned about England and Portugal and Spain more and how they were close to each other, what was around. So he wanted knowledge to be prepared for. So read 170 or 161, then 162 is the conclusion. It kind of just goes over the social systems, the political and economic systems, and the cultures again. Study that. I've posted a PowerPoint. I've also posted a review sheet that things you should know, and a Jeopardy game. So there's lots of information for you. Please look them over.